This is Didi.
Yes,
Pranks.
Reaction.
And fitness. What's good, ladies and gentlemen? This is Didi and CCTV. Man, we got a good banger for you guys. We got a try not to laugh challenge that came from you guys in the comment sections. We got a try not to laugh challenge to Boondocks. It's three different episodes in Boondocks, but we're going to do it in one. They kind of short, so we're going to do them in one. The first one we're going to react to is the fundraiser. If you haven't watched Boondock Saints, this shit is so funny. I always check up, so I might get caught. We're going to make our own challenge to each other. What is your challenge if I laugh first?
You have to do whatever I tell you.
All right. My challenge, if she laughs first, my challenge to her is she have to do whatever I tell her. She have to give me whatever I want to drink, when I want to drink, anytime I want it. And let's see, she has to go on her Facebook page and put that my husband behind every post. I want you to put "my husband is king" after every time you post something.
Okay.
Exactly. So that's what we doing in the comments, man. Y'all guys put it. We're gonna do that right now for you guys. We are doing Boondocks. The first one we're gonna react to is called the fundraiser. The second one is called Out of Chicken. The third one we're gonna react to is called what was it? Oh, R. Kelly, the R. Kelly trial. So y'all let us know what y'all like and what y'all think about this reaction. This is Try Not to Laugh. The rules of Try Not to Laugh is you can do all that, but if you you lose a thing. If she chuckles first. Whoever chuckles first, the rules is off. We both can laugh. But if she laughs first, be the first person to laugh, she gotta do what I say. And if I gotta do what I say. So let's go ahead and get it, man. We're gonna go to the first one that says, "I always laugh, so I might lose." This one is Boondocks. Affirmative.
Hope you don't mind. We made some tea. Allow me to introduce myself. I'm the bloke you're stealing from. The name's Alistair Rigby, but as far as you're concerned, I'm Willy fucking Wonka, and you're taking a shit in my fucking chocolate factory. Easy, boss. Don't get upset. When I have to go to the dentist, I'm upset. When Liverpool beats Arsenal, I'm upset. But when some little shit decides to take over one of the most profitable territories in the country, I'm beyond fucking upset. I'm very fucking upset. So, from now on, you're under new management. You will work for me, and in return, you'll receive an allowance.
Allowance?
Yes, allowance. As in, I'm allowing you to keep 10%, and I'm allowing you to keep drawing breath on this earth. Now, you either get down or you lay down. What's it gonna be, sunshine?
This wasn't no movie. The smart thing was to say it.
All right, pause. I gotta let y'all know something. The story behind this. Fundraiser is an episode in Boondocks. You ever saw it before? All right. Fundraiser is an episode in Boondocks where Riley, his character, chooses to become a fundraiser at school, and it was a friendly fundraiser to raise money for charity for their school by selling candy. He went into an idea and said, you know what, instead of selling the money, giving it to the school, we're going to sell the money and keep it ourselves. So he bought a whole bunch of chocolate and started selling the chocolate and made Goku money. He took over a lot of territories. He put out a lot of chocolate companies out of business in these episodes. And a lot of people came for him. And especially the drug dealer that he's in front of came for him because people wasn't buying drugs no more. People was just buying chocolate for their kids. And the people were getting addicted to the chocolate parents. So this is the scene. And he's acting like he's in a movie. If y'all don't know what apartment that is or what office that is the office that Tony Montana. That's Tony Montana's office. In the scene that it looks like, that's Tony Montana from the movie. So let's go ahead and get into it. All right.
Yes, get up and leave the room. But then I thought to myself, what if this was a movie? Look, fuck you. Fuck the plane you flew in on. Fuck them shoes. Fuck the socks with the bell on it. Fuck your gay-ass fairy faggot accent. Fuck them cheap-ass cigars. Fuck your yuck-mouth teeth. Fuck your hairpiece. Fuck your chocolate. Fuck Guy Ritchie. Fuck Prince William. Fuck the Queen. This is America. My president is black and my Lambo is blue, nigga. Now get the fuck out of my hotel room. And if I see you in the street, I'm slapping the shit out of you.
I think this one spent so much time in the cinema. Teach this cheeky bastard a lesson. Somebody fucking move!
Oh man, this is bad.
What is this? A casting call for the Sopranos reunion? Do me a favor, tell room service nobody here ordered the extra large wop with a side order of wops.
Whoa! Jesus Christ, I thought he'd never shut up. So, you guys are probably wondering why we just kicked in the door and shot your boss here in the face. Well, to be honest, it's tough times out there. Nobody's spending on nothing. No drugs, no whores, no gambling, nothing. Except, apparently, chocolate bars. So, consider this a hostile take... over. We got a problem?
No, absolutely not.
No.
Okay, have a nice day. Now get the fuck out of here.
Fundraiser one. That was that was tough for me. The next one is Boondocks Out of Chicken. This one is, this actually happened in real life when they did it years before the Popeye's Chicken Sandwich came out, but this is a symbol of what was to come when the Popeye's Chicken Sandwich came out. this scene of this episode right here was, even though they used KFC, it was actually Popeyes they were talking. Let's get it.
Man, this chicken gonna be off the chain. I can't wait. I'm gonna get some chicken. I can't wait.
So you kids don't know how lucky you have it. All my life, we only had 11 herbs and spices. This is a whole new... Oh.
A two-piece special with lots of hot sauce and all the fries you can give me.
Boy, wake up. It's almost chicken time. What? I can't believe what you're telling me. What? No way. No goddamn way. Hell no. What is it? These motherfuckers talking about they out of chicken. What? Listen.
Welcome to Colonel's Fried Chicken. Unfortunately, we are out of chicken at the moment. Please go wait until we have more chicken. Thank you. God bless.
They ran out of chicken?
Aw, man. This is some old bullshit.
No chicken? You mean I ain't gonna be able to get that bucket?
How can they be out of chicken? It's Colonel's Fried Chicken.
This is outrageous. This is an outrage.
Hello? 911? No, I ain't calling a snitch. I got a real emergency. Yeah.
Some of us have been looking forward to this day for a long, long time.
Hello, my emergency. These fools just ran out of chicken.
Welcome to Colonel's Fried Chicken. Unfortunately, we are...
I ain't this motherfucker until I kiss my chicken. That's what they do. Keep screwing the little man. Not going to get away with this.
You're right. Hey, he's right. It's time for us to fight back. Let's knock some motherfuckers out about this chicken.
We are not going to take it in
there. Damn, I'm chicken. That's a fool.
Tonight, civil unrest explodes in several major American cities. There have been reports of fires, looting, and violence in the streets, all over a fast food promotion gone terribly wrong. As the first customers tasted the new secret recipe, reviews were stellar.
Yo, motherfucker, this shit is bad as fuck. Yo, put this shit in your mouth, man. Eat that motherfucker. Eat it.
But early on in the day, there were signs of trouble. Impatient crowds, drive-through lines stretching for miles, scuffles between tired and hungry customers.
How you gonna say you got chicken and you ain't got no chicken? You knew y'all was gonna do this for a year. I'm supposed to be my family now. I want my chicken. My baby.
She said, how the fuck am I supposed to feed my Jesus Christ. If y'all know about the Popeye's chicken sandwich, that shit actually happened in real life. They actually had a female go up to Popeye's and say that shit. This one is, the last one is, wow. This last one was the R. Kelly trial. This shit was just... Whew, this one was hilarious as well. The Boondocks R. Kelly trial. This was some real shit. And I appreciate that Boondocks put that out there. And they let that shit be known. That this is what R. Kelly needed. And this for the first time in a long time that people actually was supposed to pay attention, but people didn't really pay attention to this. Let's go ahead and get to it. This one is the Boondocks, the R. Kelly trial.
I'm like the life.
If you're good.
Wait.
I'm like the life.
If you're good, Santa Claus might give you a gold.
Wait. Alright. Here we go, y'all.
Hey, boys. Hey there, Huey.
Riley.
I couldn't help but notice your sign, and I hope you boys aren't too upset about me having to prosecute Mr. Kelly.
Hey, man, you do what you gotta
do. Why R. Kelly, huh? What did R. Kelly do to you?
He's accused of relieving himself on an underage girl on tape, which is against the law.
Okay. But let's examine this whole peeing thing so I can pee in the toilet and it's okay. But if I pee on a person, it's like not okay.
Well, yeah.
Well, what if I'm peeing and Huey's in the bathroom and I accidentally pee on Huey? Should I go to jail?
What the hell would I be doing in the bathroom while you're in the bathroom?
Hold up. Remember when we used to sleep in the same bed when we was littler?
Littler?
From time to time, I'd have a little accident.
You still do?
Shut up! So, Mr. Dubois, Mr. I wanna lock niggas up for peeing. What's the statute of limitations on bedwetting? Why not prosecute me and R. Kelly at the same time, huh?
Now, Riley, no one's going to prosecute you for bedwetting.
And you shouldn't. It's a natural bodily function, and now every nigga in the world gonna be scared to pee. I may never pee again.
Riley, it was a little girl.
Oh, I seen that girl. She ain't little. I'm little.
Yes.
Gary Coleman's little.
Yes.
Mini-Me is little.
Very.
And to the best of my knowledge, we all managed to avoid getting peed on so far.
But what about the victim?
Oh, yes, the victim. At what point does personal responsibility become a factor in this equation?
I don't think that.
I see piss coming, I move. She saw piss coming, she stayed.
Yeah, she did.
And why should I have to miss out on the next R. Kelly album just for that? Man, you just got beat by an 8-year-old. And if R. Kelly goes to jail, I'll piss on your cat.
All right. So this is leading up to it, y'all. This is leading up to it. To the trial. Here you go.
That situation was different. That was family.
We're here at the R. Kelly trial, where there are a handful of angry protesters making their voices heard. These are scholars, activists, pillars of the African-American community, and they are outraged. And we're just going to head over here to R. Kelly's supporters, where it's quite the festive event. And you are...
Hey!
Now, why did you come out here to support R. Kelly?
'Cause he good!
And what about those protesters over there who say he's crossed the line?
Literate-ass uppity niggas. All they talk about is reading and eating right. Nobody want to hear all that shit. If I want to get high blood pressure, then nigga, get the carrot away from me. If I want to get high blood pressure, then damn it, that's my business.
Let's talk to another R. Kelly supporter.
That's crazy.
Oh, you there, urban youth. Why do you think R. Kelly is innocent?
If I started peeing on you right now, would you A, smile and ask for more, or B, move the hell out the way? But before you answer that, let me ask America, has pee ever really hurt anybody? And I want to give a big shout out to my homie, Devo. What's up? Okay, that's enough. Oof. Get off me! Get off me, Huey! Free R. Kelly!
Hey, yo, look, the R. Kelly head is oppressing that little boy.
Free R. Kelly! Free R. Kelly!
We're gonna pop Piper.
Mr. Kelly, do you have a statement?
This is truly an example of black people sticking together. In the words of Sister Soldier, an injustice anywhere is an injustice anywhere. Amen.
What did O.J. Simpson say to Kobe at
the right statement is an injustice everywhere. It's injustice everywhere. But, alright. Let's go to this part right here. We're gonna go to this part right here. Hold on. Now this part right here is where Huey came and said some shit that a lot of people needed to hear, but people still wouldn't catch it. And, wait, hold on.
That's Hugh?
That's Hugh, yeah.
It really is racism.
Yeah. Oh, you said it right there.
Yeah.
Here we go.
They got the thongs all up the booty crack, and they got that sweet white nectar. Oh, Lord have mercy. And after that, it's over. You wake up and you don't even know what you done done. Just a pool of sweat.
Wait. I told you.
Order.
Wait.
Would you describe yourself as an African-American woman?
Nigga, you blind?
No, I'm not. So it's safe to say that R. Kelly is sexually attracted to black women, right?
Mm-hmm.
Objection, relevance.
Wait,
we vote, kid, carry on in grace.
Well, how about this? Game.
Here we go.
They don't want you to see something that would blow this case wide open. This is R. Kelly's NAACP Image Award Certificate of Nomination.
Oh. Hey, man, you got his card. He's good. Did you wash your hands?
You think they nominate just anyone for this award?
I got one.
You know why he wants to put R. Kelly in jail? Because he's afraid of R. Kelly. Oh. Objection!
Would you be quiet?
I think he's afraid. I think the whole system is afraid of R. Kelly.
Your Honor, please! If you don't shut up!
They're afraid because they see the power for good that this man wields through his music. Yes, they do. They don't want R. Kelly to be free because they don't want you to be free. They don't want me to be free. Maybe R. Kelly did urinate on this woman, but America urinated on R. Kelly.
Oh.
And if you let them put this man in jail, America will urinate on each and every one of you. Salaamu alaikum.
Walaikum alaikum salam, brother.
Please, people, you saw the tape. The girl testified she was underage. You're not allowed to do that to a little girl. We have a videotape.
Go tell that to your white bitch.
But the girl was... prosecution rests.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, all that needs to be said is this.
This is the best part. We're about to go up that tasty pit, boy.
Charges, but R. Kelly is not one of those men. We all know the nigga can sing, but what happened to standards? What happened to bare minimums? You a fan of R. Kelly? You want to help R. Kelly? Then get some counseling for R. Kelly. Introduce him to some older women. Hide his camcorder. But don't pretend like the man is a hero. And stop the damn dancing. Act like you got some goddamn sense, people. Damn! Don't play it around here! Boo! Hey, you with the afro! Give it a rest! Beat it! Put the music back on! You stressing me? I did battle with ignorance today, and ignorance won. I admit that I'm often vexed at the behavior of my own people. Yeah, vexed is a good word.
I told you about messing with them white women.
You do what you can to help black folks, and they make you wonder why you even bother. But they're our people, and we gotta love them regardless. One thing for sure, though, can't blame this one on the white man. What am I saying? Of course I can.
Shout out to Harry Newton. Shout out to Robbie Newton. The Boondocks. Gina King. Huh? That's people that's in the... That's the one who... The people that's voices. Who play the voices of the characters. Shout out to Pops, a.k.a. John Witherspoon. The characters of Boondocks, man. Rest in peace to him as well. Boondocks was a great show. That trial... He said some real shit that a lot of people didn't pay attention to. That I believe in R. Kelly. I believe that the man is a innocent man. I believe that he's a victim of his own circumstances. Because R. Kelly was being raped as a kid. Nobody cared. And the parents of those children who allowed him to have their children is a reason to be blamed as well. This man is sitting in jail right now while the parents is being out free. And they were the ones that gave their children up to go be with R. Kelly. So I think if you're going to blame R. Kelly, you should blame the parents. That's just me.
Wait. So they gave the underage children?
They gave the girl that he had sex with that was on that tape, I think she was 12. The reason she even got a chance to go to the R. Kelly concert to even see R. Kelly backstage and then to go to R. Kelly's hotel room is because the mama of that just said young lady bought a ticket for her daughter to go. And reason why they were extorting, if you don't know what that means, they were trying to bribe him out of money. They were telling him, we'll let you have sex with our daughter, but you gotta pay us. They paid, R. Kelly paid those women a lot of money. He paid the other woman that surviving R. Kelly stupid ass series that came out. He paid all those women parents off as well. Mainly their moms. None of their daddies was involved. None of the daddies signed up. That tells a lot about that these women pimped out their daughters to have R. Kelly to be around their daughters. And now that they want to lock R. Kelly up and throw away the key, I think they should do the same thing for the parents because the parents got money off it. That's just me. This is a long video. If you made it to the end of this, man, please go ahead and I want you guys, if you made it to the end of this, I want you guys to go ahead and say what's my middle name. That'll let me know that you made it to the end of the video. My middle name is going to be Michael. If you let us know what my last name is. What's up?
And my middle name is Tanika.
If you let us know what our middle name is, do the end of the video. We will go ahead and give you a big, big shout out in the next video. But you gotta watch to the end of the video to let us know what our nicknames, our middle names is. Michael and Tanika. If you let us know what that is, man, we'll go ahead and give you a shout out. And we'll go ahead and do a personal video that you want. A personal video, whatever video you wanted to be. Prank, reaction, fitness, whatever you want us to do, we'll go ahead and do it for you guys. But you gotta let us know what our nicknames is. And the only way you can find out, you gotta watch the whole video. Thank you guys for watching the video. We are Didi. Pranks and fitness. Peace.